Hello, folks. Welcome to tonight's game. This one's going to be good between the Georgetown Hoyas and the Maryland Terrapins. And there are the starting lineups for each team.
A great matchup at the shooting guard position. I think we should keep an eye on this one, Brad.
We've got a really interesting matchup here tonight at the shooting guard position. Number three is the type of player that can shoot the ball without effort from three-point land. He's got a beautiful stroke.
Starting across from him tonight is a player known more as a floor general or an extension of the coach out there.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out. Well, here we go. Georgetown wins control of the tip and brings it up court. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important, get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I'll tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Controlling the ball. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way?
Up and inside.
Goes with a jump hook.
I tell you, the jump hook so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Looking for a good shot. They get an open three. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
The point guard takes the feed. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, the coaching staff knew this would be a key heading into tonight's matchup. This is something they stressed during pregame, and it's something they're talking about on the benches right now. The message, get the ball inside. Guys, they're doing that.
All right, Erin, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
Harrison receives the pass. 10 seconds to get a shot off. Picks off the lazy pass. The layup. Gave it up for the bucket, up and in. Now they get some additional instruction from their coach for this defensive possession.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. They go with the entry pass on the post, turnaround jumper. Grabs it.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
The fans start to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Perfectly executed. On the outside. Thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Erin Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. A little two-man action. Goes up for two. The lay-in. They've got a player spotting up on the three.
Look at that spacing.
Two. The ball goes out of play. It's time now to look at the ideal tempos for each team. It seems like we got two different tempos facing off against one another here, Dick.
You know, the battle for controlling the tempo is always exciting when two styles contrast like these two. Let's hope both teams rise to the challenge and we see the best of both tempos fight for the win.
Fed the low block with the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I'll tell you, great spin move to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. Ten on the shot clock. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Dixon handles the pass. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up. Time to pick up the defense here now. On the dribble, gives it up. Pull-up jumper, left side. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
He shoots from the top of the circle. The Hoyas have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
For two, up and in. The Hoyas are all about playing in the half court and controlling the tempo, wouldn't you say, Dick?
They'll never force a shot and will rarely get into a running game, Brad. They realize that they can't play that style and be successful.
The power forward takes the feed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down on the low block.
A very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Court. Tries for two. The lane. They work the perimeter. Seconds showing on the shot clock. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
A little half-court action, a little fast breaking, Brad. As a result, we have a balanced tempo reading.
The small forward handles the pass. Number 33 comes up with it. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
That stat doesn't surprise me, Brad. The pace of the game has been pretty slow.
Number one gets the ball. They'll work it around the arc. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Perfectly executed. On the outside. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad, both coaching staffs expected this to be an even matchup. Who will throw the first punch, and how will the other react?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
The missed shot. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Up and in. Dixon handles the pass. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Number 22 takes the pass, tries for two, and in and out. For the bucket, and they don't score there either. Now looking to attack. The lay-in. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
With lots of room. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Hey, currently the tempo is definitely on the high side, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Up and in. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Gave it up. He tries the jumper. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
The small forward takes the feed. The ball handler might be in trouble here. Great defense, forcing a call of 5 seconds. Number 50 sees his first action of the day.
Man, I love to watch this kid play, Brad. He's the type of player who knows how to really lift the team.
He takes the shot off the baseline, scorches the net with a J. Working it around the perimeter. The crowd is definitely doing their thing. Listen to the chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
And the ball goes out of bounds. Number 44 makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
Nicholas handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. Dick, you think they're going to stay this hot?
Hey, doesn't look like they're slowing down, my friend.
They work it around the perimeter. Got to give that 5 second call to the defense. Number 41 makes his first substitution.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor.
For two, the lay-in.
Dump it inside.
Tries for two, misses a shot from in close. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Coach has been quite animated over here on the sidelines. It's all positive, though. He's pleased with the manner in which they're playing their up-tempo style. I overheard him saying that if this continues, he likes his team's chances. Guys?
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. For the bucket. They still don't score. Thompson receives the ball. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
Skill, that's the word, my friend. That comes to mind when I look at this young guy. He can score being faced up to the hoop or with his back to the basket.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. Up and in. Looks like they want a T.O., Nick.
Hey, the motor's running, baby. Coach has got to figure out how to stop this run.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you gotta think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Pushes it up. The ball goes out of bounds. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper for two. Perfectly executed. Tries for two. Off the mark from in close. Thompson handles the pass. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Halftime, the Hoyas are trailing by two. If you missed the play of the half, here's another look. All right, Mr. Vitale, how about those points of emphasis?
Yeah, I've done a poor job with points of emphasis. We brought up earlier. Teams are successful when they play their style and dictate the tempo. This has not been the case so far with them.
Let's see how things will change or remain the same going into the second half. Maryland is showing tremendous accuracy from the floor in the first half, partner.
They're so well coached, man. Working the ball around for the high percentage shot. That's a lot of maturity, man. They really are a mature basketball team.
Dick, it's all about teamwork, and as we start the second half and take a look at our player matchup update, it's pretty even.
I'll tell you, really great balance out there because you look at the stars right now, they're getting the ball in the right place on the court where they can be effective.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He goes with a baby hook. He cleans the glass. Pushes it up. Goes up for two. The Terrapins have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Gave it up. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
The Hoyas have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
They get an open look for three. Goes. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The defense is really commanding the tempo.
Hey, they're keeping them out of sync. Side
for two, the land. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
That's exactly what I was thinking, Brad. The pace of this game has been remarkable.
Tries for two, in and out. The shooting guard gets the ball. Looking for a good shot. Seconds remaining on the shot clock. The power forward takes the pass. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. Steals a pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, it's well-executed two-man game. It's always a treat to watch.
Gave it up for the bucket. Perfectly executed. On the outside. He's in the clear. And he buries the three. Here's the three ball. He can't get the bucket to fall. Brown handles the pass. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. The point guard with the ball.
Look at that spacing. They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Let's it fly. Shots off the mark. Up and in. They work it around the perimeter. For two, the layup. Turnaround jumper. He gets the board. Harrison handles the feed. Cross court. He takes the open jumper. He misses from beyond the arc.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Tries for two. Up and in. go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Coach has been very animated over here on the sidelines. His team is doing a great job of following strategy and playing that up-tempo style. I'm sure he'll continue to encourage them over the course of the game to ensure they don't stray away from what's working.
Thanks, EA. Aaron Andrews providing that extra bit of insight for us. Cross court. 10 on the shot clock. For the bucket. And in and out. Ball kicked out from the post. Goes up for two. He gets another one to go.
This is a shooting clinic, my friend.
On the dribble, gives it up. Ten on the shot clock. Gave it up. The lay-in. Wide, wide open. Wilcox drills the three. They work the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
Wilcox handles the feed. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad, in regards to our player matchup, the coaching staff has expected it to be evenly matched up across the board all night long. But you wonder, who's going to be the first one to throw the punch?
Aaron Andrews, always close to the action. Looking for a good shot. That's the luxury of the home court advantage. You have the crowd chanting, jumping around, fired up. It is awesome.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Here comes the ball screen. Wide open. And nice looking jumper in the lane. On the dribble, gives it up. The Terrapins are going to try to hold on to the lead here, but should probably do so by playing in the half court as opposed to that up-tempo style, Dick.
At this point, playing in the half court would be a wise move. They don't really need to score, but do need for time to come off the clock.
The Hoyas are going to have to make some modifications here, Dick. They're going to have to throw out the idea of playing in the half court and get this into more of an up-tempo game.
Hey, the clock nor the score is in their favor. They're going to have to switch up their style and play completely up-tempo. They should be looking to press and score quickly, Brad.
Harrison handles the feed. They'll work it around the arc. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Dixon receives the pass. Cross court. For two. Up and in. Now let's take a look here at the tempos for both these teams tonight.
Well, it looks like both of them are going to be battling to see who can control the tempo and put pressure on the opponent.
Tries for two. Lays it in. Pushes it up. And the ball goes out of play. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
Cross court. Looks at a three. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
On the outside, as the fans chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Now they work it around the perimeter. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
The baseline inbounds. He just can't escape the pressure.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
The shot from the baseline. Nails the J. That's going to be charging.
I disagree, but great play.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Fires away. He shows the sweet touch. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
The turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
That stat doesn't surprise me, Brad. The pace of the game has been pretty slow.
Picks off the lazy pass. Pushes it up for the bucket with a layup. Gave it up. Jumper. The Hoyas have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding them the ball. It's simple.
Inside. Now the turnaround jumper. Takes the rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. The lead is five. What happens now, Dick?
Well, this is where momentum can swing in your favor or go against you enough to blow your game.
He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Cross court. He shoots from right of the circle. He misses the jumper. Up for the lay-in. 7 points right now is the difference in this one.
Hey, Brad, 7 points is no safe haven. You got to keep pressing.
He goes up with it. He misses the J. Blake receives the pass. How can you not love this game and the hoopla and fanfare that goes along with it?
The Ruckus fans are going nuts. They're going bananas, Brad.
Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Nobody likes this point in the game, and the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And yet another foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Brown fouls out. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. So they'll inbound on the near sideline. Foul, and that stops the clock again. This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Buries it. Second shot is no good. Well, the coach doesn't like what he's seeing right now. He's called a timeout. They could be starting to pull away here, Dick.
They should try for an early foul here.
And yet another foul. He goes to the line for the first time. Rims out. He gets the rebound. Coach calls for a timeout. He wants to talk some things over. Surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
On the dribble, gives it up. For two. Two with a lay-in. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. He steps up to the line. Misses the front end of the one and one. Timeout's been called. Let's check in with Aaron.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Coach seemed pretty intense on that one, Dick.
Hey, you can have all the X's and O's you want, but if you aren't ready to lay it on the line and wear your heart on your sleeve, then college basketball isn't for you.
Come on. game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
Gave it up. Dick, he's going to go up strong.
Oh, that's a terrific post play. Didn't waste any time attacking the basket.
That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
He'll go to the line. First one is good. He makes them both. Timeout's called.
Time is not on their side right now, Brad. They need some big shots, baby.
We might see a little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Dick, what are your final thoughts and how these teams play?
Well, I look at those as suggestions and clues which should help a team get the W. Obviously, the more check marks, the better. I get concerned when a team completely neglects the points of emphasis and plays completely out of style.
Every game's unique, and in every game, it's up to the players to control the tempo and their team's ideal style of play. You do it consistently, you're going to win more games. Seems simple to me. Dick, we know the TV business. You've got to have marquee matchups, but it's still about team basketball.
I'll tell you one thing. The team has really responded as a unit, and they're taking advantage of the abilities of their stars.
Maryland finally pulls this close one out.
But two teams like this, you knew the game was going to be close.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.